In this video, the 7 key ideas from Blue Fishing by Steve Sims, featuring the man who introduced me to Steve Sims, Will Collette.
All right, what is up, guys? If you're watching this, that means you got another day. We're out here in West Hollywood, California for a special interview with my guy, Brendan, because we're gonna be talking about blue fishing. Okay, so the first guy that really kind of taught me my secret to sliding in the DMs was Steve Sims. And that's because when I first met him in person, I wanted to be a part of what he was doing. You know, I was looking forward to getting out of the Air Force soon, and I knew that I had to line up something in LA. So I was like, all right, look, Steve, whatever you're doing, I want to be a part of it. Whatever you need, I'll do it. And he was like, you know, I appreciate the offer, but to be frank, no thanks. And he's like, I'll give you a piece of advice that's more valuable. And that is, anytime you reach out to somebody, and I'm seeing this now because I'm getting these types of DMs from people that follow me. If you give somebody the broad, I'll do anything for you, you actually just gave them a task. You gave them work to do.
Yeah, they gotta figure it out.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So if you reach out to someone, if you wanna reach out to someone, connect with anybody, high or low level, you need to make sure that one, when you reach out, it has to be something in the form of delivering value to them without expectation of anything in return. And it has to be phrased in the form of a question where all they have to do is say yes or no.
I like that.
And that's the key to sliding in the DMs.
Beautiful. All right. Key idea number two, I would say from this book, is the danger of being too conformist. And you and I, when you told me about this book, I remember we were at Neptune's Net out in Malibu, and we were both still in the military.
Yeah.
And I think we were both a little bit frustrated with all of the structure around us.
Yeah.
And I think all the conformism. And I think like what Steve talks about in this book is that when you break out of that and you start to see yourself acting differently, and you're not afraid to be embarrassed, you're not afraid to look a little different from the group, that's when you reach excellence. That's when you can have success. And then when you see people who are successful, you start to see, maybe I could be like that. Maybe I could have this exceptional progress when you start to have a non-conformist mindset.
100%. The next idea here that he talked about was related to his passwords. So getting to, he was working at like what, nightclubs, right?
Yeah, he was a bouncer.
Yeah, so he was like a bouncer at these nightclubs, and he always came up with a password to get in. And the passwords are always something silly. And this is kind of where his title originated, Bluefishing, because the password one of the nights was like one fish, two fish, red fish, blank. And you had to have the answer to the password. And obviously it wasn't rocket science, but what it required was for you to kind of let your ego out of the way because you had to say something as silly as bluefish, or when it was, you know, the password was Tinky Winky. It was literally a Teletubby's name.
Yeah.
And you have these high level, this is not like an average run-of-the-mill nightclub. Like, this is a high level, high exec. You got to be somebody to know somebody to get invited. And when you step in and the only thing keeping you from getting into this like very exclusive event is the name of a Teletubby. And I think it's really funny that like he was able to have a particular crowd that one was very successful and high level, but also were the type of people that weren't afraid to be either just a little human or a little childish and just accept the fact that like maybe your ego isn't everything. Like you can let that down and use Teletubby as and some people wouldn't do it. Some people literally would not say it and would just refuse and say, you know, let me in. I already know what the password is. You and I know, I know. And they literally can't say it. And he's like, all right, there's no party in here. And there's like all these people raging behind him. He's like, there's no party here.
Yeah.
And they would just get so frustrated because they couldn't come to terms with just being at that level. And I just thought that was so funny that people's ego would get that much in the way of preventing something good or exciting that's right in front of them.
Totally. You know? Yeah. Yeah, Steve talked about that when we did the interview, and maybe I'll cut in a clip here or something, but yeah, it's so funny to hear him tell that story of like acting like there's nothing happening when there's a raging party on a yacht behind him. Key idea number four is all about facing rejection, and Steve has a list in the book of all these famous people who faced a ton of rejection. A couple that stand out, Stephen King, he wrote Carrie. He got rejected by something like 30 publishers. At one point, he threw it out. And his wife actually fished it out of the trash.
Oh my God.
This is the book that launched the career of maybe the most successful writer in the world right now. And all after all of that rejection. So if you're getting rejected, stick with it. Another one is Dwight Eisenhower. He's a great general, became president of the United States. This guy was rejected by the US Naval Academy. So stake on the part of the Navy, we accept that. But you know, totally, you can face rejection and still go on to do great things in your life, but you have to be able to roll through it and keep trying.
All right, number five. Number five was the power to say no. And this one, especially right now, rings true. Mm-hmm. Because when I rolled into 2020, I was like, okay, there's a lot of stuff on my plate right now. I became laser focused on becoming a full-time YouTuber. Mm-hmm. And I realized that there were so many distractions, people robbing me of my time. There were apps stealing my time. There was content creation, like collabs and things like that, that weren't serving me. And there's mm-hmm. nothing wrong with, you know, helping other people or collaborating or things like that. Yeah. But I was saying yes to everything.
Yeah.
And it was overwhelming. And not only was I saying yes to too many opportunities, I was saying yes or passively accepting people who were actively robbing me, like negative people, toxic people, in the comments, in the DMs, in real life. And I even had a roommate that was exceptionally toxic. And I think there's a two-step to having the power to say no. And one is having the clarity to be able to recognize something that is toxic, because oftentimes we get friends that are just comfortable to be around, or people in our circle that are comfortable to be around. They might not be serving, now they don't have to be serving you in the sense like they're just doing all your chores, but serving you in the iron sharpens iron sense. So like you wanna surround yourself with people that are in the mindset of leveling up. And if they're not on that game plan and you are, they are just holding you back. And there's nothing wrong with limiting the amount of time, even if it means cutting those types of people out of your life, if you are more focused on a bigger goal. And the power to say no is hard to learn, especially if, you know, if you have people that are comfortable in your life like that. But have the clarity to identify and then have the power, essentially, to say no to those opportunities and those people.
Number six is that everything that is stagnant rots. And like, I think we can look to nature, for example. This Steve talks about being in California, we deal with wildfires.
Yeah.
And, I mean, you know this as well as I do.
Yeah.
But the thing is, after a wildfire, we have the super blooms. Like, I remember after the Woolsey fire, where I had to evacuate my home, I left the country for a while. Mm-hmm. When we come back, we had the super bloom. You come over to my place, the flowers are amazing. You're shooting models.
Yeah, we did model shooting the flowers.
Out in the flowers. You know, these things happen when there is a natural turnover. And I think in life too, we need to have like a controlled burn. You don't want a wildfire, but you need to have a controlled burn. You need to have times when you shed things, when you let go of stuff. Like you were talking about dumping the apps that are taking your time.
Deleted Instagram today.
Absolutely.
Bye.
Good for you, really. So I think that is another thing. Everything that is stagnant rots. We need to be continuously changing.
I like that.
The idea number seven, the final takeaway from this, is that the key to unlocking doors is listening. That's something Steve says in this book. And you can see this, so much of this book, I think, is about being around the right people. Steve's got an amazing network. And you can see when you meet people that if you listen to them, if you do the listening, if you are interested rather than being interesting, I know that's kind of trite, but it really matters. People will respond to that. And when you're trying to connect with high-level people or people you want to learn from, then to bother to actually stop and listen to them is going to get you way further than going on and on about yourself. Like, you must experience this at car shows and stuff.
You know how you talk about like not being the smartest person in the room? Like, you don't want to be the smartest person in the room? Like sometimes, this is great, when I'm around people that I look up to, or maybe when someone that looks up to me is around me, they are like, oh my God, it's Will. And then they talk and talk and talk and talk.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And then they leave and they leave with nothing, you know? And it's like, we've had some high level people that we've met even with Jay or anyone else in our circle. And it's like, if you spend the whole time talking, all you did was you learned nothing. You can only learn if you listen.
Right. That's an awesome note to end on. I'll leave the outro to you, my friend.
Okay. All right. All right, Brendan uploads videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to his channel, make sure you click that notification bell, make sure you drop a comment, say something if you've read a book or know somebody that is in that power circle that you wanna flex, that you're like, look, this is someone I'm learning from and you should learn from them too, and we will catch you guys at the next episode. Peace.